Welcome back to AJSpeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to use the chunking method with long division. First, let's begin with just a short, quick review. Let's say we have the number 488 being divided by 4. Well, the number 4 on the outside is our divisor, and the number 448 on the inside is our dividend. And then once we get our answer here, that answer is going to be called the quotient. Alright, so let's work on this first problem, and we're going to use the same problem here. We have 488. We want to divide that by 4. Alright, in a previous video we talked about using the acronym Does McDonald's Sell Burgers for division, multiplication, subtraction, and then bring down. For some students, they have difficulty remembering it even when they know the acronym. So here's another method that we call the chunking method, and we use basic multiplication facts to help us. All right, we start by looking at our divisor, and our divisor is 4. So we're going to multiply that divisor by 1, and of course we know that's 4. Then we're going to multiply that divisor by 10, and again, that should be an easy multiplication problem. So we know that there is going to be 40. And then let's jump down and do 4 times 100, and that there is going to give us 400. And we know when we multiply by 10, all you do is tack on zeros each time. Now we're going to take a step back and say, all right, let's do 4 times 5. I chose 5 because I took half of this 10. Well, if I take half of this, I need to take half of the product. So half of 40 gives me 20. And then I'm going to use the same thinking here where I have 100, but I'm going to take half of that 100 to give me 50. So that means I take half of this 400 to give me 200. And then another easy one is to take this 10 and then double it. Well, if I double 10, I get 20. And if I double the 10, I need to double the 40 to get 80. So now I have multiple facts I can use to help me try to figure out how many times 488 can be divided by 4. Let's find our largest number without going over 488. And we see our largest number we have here is 400. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write 400 here. And then I'm going to write the fact right behind it, which is going to be 4 times 100. Now I'm going to do the subtraction. Well, 488 minus 400 leaves me with 88. Now I have 88, but I want to find a number that's close to 88 without going over. And we see here I have 80. So I'm going to use 80 down here. And then I'm going to write the multiplication fact, which is 4 times 20. Then I'm going to do my subtraction. I have 88 minus 80, which just leaves me with 8. And now at this point, we should know that it's 4 times 2, but let's say you didn't, so we need to find the number that's close to 8 without going over. We see that's the number 4, so we write our 4, and then we write the fact, which is 4 times 1. We do our subtraction, 8 minus 4 to give us 4, and again, 4 is a number that we don't want to go over, so we see that we're exactly at 4. So we're going to write our 4 down here, and we're going to write the fact, which is 4 times 1. And we're going to do our subtraction, and you see we're at 0. And that's our indication that we're finished. Once we get here to 0, we have to look back at the facts that we wrote. And our focus is on the numbers that are not the divisor. We see 4 is our divisor. We don't want that. We want the other factor. All right, now that we have the other factors, we need to add those up. So we have 100 plus 20 to give us 120. So these here are used. And then I have 1 and 1, which I know is 2. So I'm going to add 120 plus the 2. So here I see that my quotient for this problem is 122. All right, let's take a look at another example. All right, for this problem, let's say that our divisor here is 5 and our dividend is 305. We're going to follow the same methodology. We're going to start with 5 times 1 to get 5. Then we're going to do 5 times 10 to get 50. And then we're going to do 5 times 100 to get 500. And then we're going to take half of 10 to give me 5. So here I've got 5 times 5, which I know is 25, but also if we take the half of the 50 to get 25. Then I'm going to double the 10, so I'm going to do 5 times 20. If I double this 10, I have to double this 50, so 50 and 50 gives me 100. And then when I come into 100, I'm going to take half of the 100 to get 50. If I take half of this 100, I have to take half of this 500, and that there is 250. So now I have basically a roadmap to help me. So I need to get as close as I can get to 305 without going over. And we see here that number is 250. So I'm going to write my 250 right here. And then I'm going to write the fact after it, which is 5 times 50. At this point, I'm going to do my subtraction. We'll have 5 take away nothing, gives me 5. And if I just focus on these two numbers here, that's 30. And these two numbers here is 25. So 30 take away 25 is just 5. So now the number I'm looking for is 55. I can't go over 55. When I look here, I see I've got the number 25, and I see the fact. So I'm going to write 25, and that fact is 5 times 5. Then I do my subtraction. 5 minus 5 is 0. 5 minus 2 is 3. And now the number is 30. I don't want to pass 30. Again, I see I can use 25. So I write in my 25, and then I write in the fact, which is 5 times 5. I do my subtraction. 30 minus 25 is 5. I don't want to go over 5. I see I have exactly 5. So I write the 5 and then I write the fact, which is 5 times 1. I do my subtraction and that there's 0. And then I place my focus on the factors other than my divisor. So that'd be these factors here. So now I have 50 plus 5 to give me 55. And then I have 5 plus 1 to give me 6. So now I have 5 plus 6 to give me 11, and then 5 plus 1 to give me 6. So here I see that my quotient, or my answer for this problem, is 61. And of course we could do the check. I'll leave the check for you to do. And let's just do one more example. All right, in this example here, let's say our divisor this time is 7. Our dividend is 714, and we're going to follow the same process. So first we're going to do 7 times 1, and of course that gives us 7, and then 7 times 10, and that gives us 70, and then 7 times 100, and that gives us 700. We're going to take half of this 10 to get 5, so we take half of this 70, which is 35. We're going to double this 10 to get 20, which means we double 70, which is just 70 plus 70 to get 140. And then last, we're going to take half of this 100 to give us 50, which means we take half of this 700, which gives us 350. All right, and another note that I failed to mention earlier, we know that once we get here with the multiple, well, we have the factor of 5. Well, if you multiply by 10, you get 50. So you just take this number here and you tack on a 0, and that'd be a faster way to figure out what the 7 times 50 was if you weren't too strong in your multiplication. All right, now we've got the number 714. We need to get as close as possible without going over, and we see that number here is 700. So we write in the 700, then we write in the fact, which is 7 times 100. And then we do our subtraction. Well, that leaves us with just 14. We don't want to go over 14. And let's say you don't know it's 7 times 2, so we're just going to go the long way. We see a 7, so we place in the 7. And then we write the fact, which is going to be 7 times 1. Now 14 take away 7 is just going to be 7. Again, we look at our list. We see that 7 is the closest number without going over, so we write in our 7. We also write in the fact, which is 7 times 1. And then 7 minus 7 gives us 0, so we know we're finished. And then we place our focus on the factors that are not the divisor. And here I have 100 plus 1 plus 1. So that's really 100 plus 2, which just gives us an answer or a quotient of 102. All right, I hope this method helps. This here is long division using the chunking method. And as always, thank you for watching.